From a makeshift office at the end of a runway, the North Korean leader watched on with glee as a long-range missile was fired over Japan. For Kim Jong-un and his generals, it was a moment of triumph. The photos released by the regime to tell the world his nuclear ambitions will not be curbed. The UN Security Council met last night and condemned his actions once again. As Donald Trump said no option is off the table, I asked one former British ambassador to North Korea to talk through those possibilities. The answers aren't optimistic. Economic sanctions should starve the regime of the funds to build weapons, but they've been imposed for decades and they're not working.
Even if you could persuade the Security Council to pass even more stringent sanctions against North Korea, getting those sanctions to stick, getting countries that matter to actually implement them would be a real uphill struggle.
What about talking? Pyongyang says no way.
They've repeated that now on, I think, seven separate occasions, word for word. It is the North Korean position written stone. They are not going to talk.
Could assassinating the leader and decapitating the regime be the answer?
He keeps his movements very secret. He travels in heavily armoured vehicles. There are always decoy vehicles. Taking him out would be really very difficult indeed and would risk an embarrassing failure.
So what about military action by the US, South Korea or Japan? North Korea's artillery is on display, but unless they can be certain of locations of nuclear missiles, a targeted strike would be difficult and could provoke a catastrophic retaliation.
All the experts agree that if you did start a war with North Korea, the casualty lists would be absolutely enormous, way, way beyond anything that we've seen in Afghanistan, Syria or Iraq.
That will be on the minds of all world leaders. Theresa May met the Japanese Prime Minister on a pre-planned visit. She wants China to step up.
We do need to put the pressure on North Korea to stop, and China does play a key role in that with the leverage that it has on North Korea. And I would encourage them to use all the leverage they have to ensure that North Korea does stop.
But the Chinese government insists it is not the answer. It's a complicated picture in this escalating crisis with so much at stake and no easy answers. Tessa Chapman, 5 News.